So how do you actually give the customer the early pay discount and record it? If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. To be able to give the early pay discount to a customer, first, you must record an invoice with the terms chosen from the terms list. The discount is given and recorded on the day that they pay. Do not give the discount on the day you create the invoice, which is the invoice date. You have to be careful to remember that because the discount box will be available when you first make the invoice. For example, let's imagine on March 30th, we did 18 editing hours for Betty and we made an invoice with these terms, the terms we created and put on the list in the previous video. Let's go ahead and record that invoice. To do this, you open the New Transaction menu. Either click on the top left where it says New, or if you don't have that, go to the top right and click the plus sign close to the cogwheel. Either one will open the same choices in the New Transaction menu. We click Invoice. We choose Betty. Okay, double check that it's Betty and it's 18 editing hours on March 30th. So we're going to make sure that it's March 30th in our little story. And it's 18 hours of editing. Is that correct? Yes. So the product or service is editing and the quantity is 18. Now, before we save this, we have to come to the terms pull down list and choose the one that we created in the previous video, 310 net 45 or whatever that was. I guess it doesn't really matter. But those are the terms that we created in the previous video. So those are the ones that we're going to add here. Now, do not put in the discount percent because we do not yet know if she's going to pay on time for the discount. So leave it blank and just put the terms. Save and close. And now we can look at Betty's open invoice report and see that another invoice for that amount has been added to her balance and the terms are stated here clearly. How do you actually record giving and paying the discount? Well, after you make the invoice and choose the term from the terms list, the discount is actually given on the day that it's paid, because that's the only way to determine if they are eligible for the discount. The person recording the payment must take the following 6 steps. Number 1, you have to reopen the invoice from the payments window. Check the terms on the invoice. Determine if the customer is eligible for the discount. If so, put in the discount percent in the discount field. Save the invoice and then go back and record the payment. And each of these steps has a reason that we are going to demonstrate right now. For example, let's imagine on March 31, Betty paid in full for the March 30 invoice. How would we record this? Well, it's very simple. We click the plus sign and we go over to the Receive Payment window. Now, we know the customer is Betty, and we know the date is March 31. Try to make it 2017. March 30th. Now, we can see by the due date and the invoice number that this is the one that Betty is paying on this date. But before we record the payment, we must double-click and open the invoice. and we must actually put the discount on the invoice. Now, when I look at the invoice date, I see that it's only one day later that we're paying. So we are definitely within the range of the discount date of the terms, and the person recording the payment has concluded that they are entitled to the discount, and the discount should be 3%. So the way to put that in would be to scroll down, and in the box that says discount percent, put the number 3 and push tab. Notice that 3% of the discount has now been calculated and taken away from the total at the bottom of the invoice. Now, at the moment we save the invoice, the discount is actually, oh, we didn't save it right. You got to be careful. Reopen it. Here we go. See, hold on. At the moment we save the invoice, oh, okay, it did it right, $75, and we're good. So the moment we do that, the balance of the invoice changes, and the discount is now recorded, even though we didn't really finish the last step and record receiving the payment. So in the split second between the moment we acknowledge the discount and the moment we acknowledge the payment, we could open up the trial balance and see that we have this account, discount given, which is the account QuickBooks created to record and track all of the early paid discounts. And it only has the $75 from that invoice. Now remember, we were supposed to record the discount at the moment we record receiving the payment. I just wanted to stop for a brief second to show you the discount is recorded and the balance of the invoice is different once we did that step. Now we must immediately finish by recording the received payment. And again, we're talking about March 30th of 2017 for Betty, and all we have to do is acknowledge the payment. Click the check mark, and the invoice already has the net amount after the discount. Save and close, and you can go back to the open. By the way, saving the payment doesn't change the discount. The discount was recorded when we changed the invoice. But remember, you should not change the invoice until you check to see if you are eligible for the discount. Now you can see that on the open invoice report, that invoice is gone and it is completely paid.